In this video, I'm going to show you how Databutton's AI Task Manager creates plans of your app for you, goes through and executes on those plans, and collaborates with you to build the app together. We're going to build a flower shop checklist app from start to finish, and you are going to see how easy it is to use Databutton to do this. Thank you to Databutton for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description if you want to go to Databutton and build this app alongside me. We've got a lot to cover in this video, so let's get into it. So go ahead and click New App. And we're going to describe on the top right what we want to build. The prompt is, I want to build a checklist app for flower shops to use when opening and closing for the day. The point of this video is to show you the power of Databutton's AI task manager and how it works. So stick with me because you're going to be really impressed with how it takes that prompt and turns it into a real app. I'm going to skip the requirements and the inspiration. For integrations, we can continue without that for now as well, because I want to focus on getting into the actual functionality as quickly as possible. I'm going to pause the video while Databutton creates the initial version of the app, and then we'll jump in once the task manager is ready. Here we are in the dashboard editor of Databutton, and then on the left side, we can see what our AI task manager has already done for us. So it sets up a plan with specific tasks, and you can see on the right side, we can start the task. And then over here on the right, we have our chat. And this is where you can see our AI task manager thinking. It even goes as far as breaking down tasks into subtasks as we start them. And then you can also modify the plan before you get started if you want. So we're going to go ahead and click task one to get started. And then as soon as you do that, you can see our AI task manager is going to start thinking. And if you click in, you can see basically what it's doing and what its thought process is. And then you can see it created subtasks within the actual task one. So it's going to update the file, and it's actually working so quickly that before I could even read it out, it started thinking it again. But here we can see it's going to update the file. It's going to apply the styling and ensure the get started button is prominent. I'm going to pause the video while it starts this coding process. And once it's done, if you go up to the top left to preview, you can see the basic landing page that it created, which is nice. And then on the right side, you can see it's kind of thinking about what it did. And on the right side, you can see here were the three tasks, the subtasks that it gave itself. You can see it checked them off that it did it. And then it thinks it's done. And then it's asking us if we should mark it as done. So it's really cool. This is something that I think is a little bit different with Databutton than other AI app builders. It really plans it out and kind of works with you to go through the tasks. So I'm going to say, yes, this is done. And then it's asking what's next on the list. So if I go over to the plan, we can see there's a few options here. So we can see the different options. I'm going to skip Firebase authentication for now. I just want to work on the functionality. So let's start with, why don't I just actually, let's see what happens if I share something specifically that I want to do. I'm going to say I want to start without authentication or database and just start with building out the functionality. Can we start building the dashboard? So I'm going to send that. And then what's cool about this is we can see it thought about it and it says that makes sense. Let's put authentication and persistence on hold through Firebase and Firestore. And let's move on to the third task of building the main checklist structure. So all I have to do is say, yes, let's do that. And it should automatically start working on the task, or I could have selected that and done it myself or pressed play. But I think it's going to start doing that itself now. So here we go. It's creating a plan. Again, like I said before, this is something that really sets Databutton apart, is that it creates a plan for the actual app. And now we can see it is writing the code. So I'm going to pause the video while it does all that. So it's finished with that. And you can even see underneath the third checklist. And if you click into it, you can see the activity and it breaks it down of what it did. And if we go back to preview, it's asking me now to click on the get started button and take a look at the dashboard. So if I do that, let's see if it works. And perfect. So here I can see on the left side, it has opening tasks. And on the right side, it has closing tasks. If I click add opening or add closing, it's not working right now, but the structure looks good. So I'm going to go ahead and mark that as done. Then if we go back to the tasks, I can just go to number 4 because this is what I want, implement checklist creation and basic task management. I'm going to click Start Task there. And just to highlight what's happening here under task 4, we can see it's creating a plan within that. So like I said before, what's really powerful is the planning here. So we can see it's planning what it's going to do within this checklist creation. And then we can see the activity as it's going through. And on the right side, we can just see even more granularly exactly what's happening. So it's finished coding, and you can see here it did a lot of tasks within this task here. And on the right side, just like we've talked about before, it basically went through and it worked through these subtasks that it planned out one by one. And we can see it checked it at the end. I like how it had this definition of done check to make sure that all like the functionality that we wanted is done. And now it's asking us to check it out. So let's go to preview. It'll load up, but just take a second. We'll click get started and let's see if it works. If I click opening or closing task, doesn't look like anything is working. So I'm going to say I'm trying to test it out, but nothing happens when I click add opening task or add closing task. So let's see what it says here and how we can debug this. Okay, so it went through and debugged. And similarly, just like when it's building out the initial features, if it's debugging, it's also going to create tasks and really think through what it's doing. And we can see here that it went through and it's telling us that it fixed it and I tested it and it did work. If I add a closing task and say, you know, shut the lights, and we can add a task here and that's going to get added. We can add another one. We can say, you know, sweep the floors and add a task. So pretty cool, just basic, you know, functionality. Of course, we can keep building onto it, but it's very cool that this is already coming together. And this is a real functional app that could provide value to so many different businesses. And it's just AI is giving us the ability now to build apps ourselves that are custom to our own use cases without having to pay a monthly SaaS fee for every piece of software that you want. Okay, so now that this is working, I'm going to go ahead and check that out and mark it as done. Okay, next I'm going to go ahead and start design and implement task completion functionality. This is pretty cool, so you're going to want to make sure you watch until this feature is complete. So just checking in here, we can see, just like before, it is planning it out and allowing us to collaborate with the AI task manager in a way that's really powerful. So the AI has finished here, and we can see it went through. Again, it reasoned through all 5 steps of the subtasks here. One thing to note is I did have a second conversation here, and this is where collaborating with the AI comes in. It was having trouble saving the code that it was writing, and it actually told me to start a new conversation. So I did that, and I started a new conversation, and then it was able to do it completely fine. I just said, keep working on this, and then it went through and solved it. So let's pause it, or let's actually test it here. So if I go to the left side, opening, let's say, turn on the lights, add task. Let's add another opening task, which is, let's say, water the plants. And add task. So here we go. We have our opening tasks, and I can check them off individually, and then it checks them off until it is complete. And I can do the same with closing tasks, like lock the door. We could say, you know, turn off air conditioning, whatever this small business would need to do. And then you could check that off. So then I'm just going to go back to our plan and check this off as done. And if we check the rest of the tasks, it's creating a shop profile, adding date handling and daily reset, and then setting up with our backend so that, you know, we can actually have data persistence and have users log in. We have plenty of other Databutton videos in the channel that cover how to connect Databutton to Firebase. Databutton makes it very easy to do that and connect to your backend to have that database and sign up, sign in functionality. But I'm going to pause here and just want to take a second to reflect on what we've built and how easy it was to collaborate with the AI task manager. And hopefully you saw kind of how advanced Databutton is to do all of this. If I were taking this to the next step, there's a few different ways that you could go. One, if you were just an individual shop owner and wanted to use this yourself, you would just have to build in the functionality to reset every day to ensure that employees were checking these off. We could even turn this into a SaaS product if you wanted to build this checklist app for small businesses to use. I imagine, you know, flower shops, which is what we were initially built this for, would want to use this. Really any small business that opens and closes, restaurants, local stores, anything like that, I could see this app actually working really well. It's like a very simple, single purpose app here. And then when you're ready to deploy, all you have to do is go up here, click deploy, and then you can deploy the app. Thank you again to Databutton for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description if you want to go to Databutton and build apps like this on your own. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more free content like this and leave a comment if you have any questions at all or if there's anything you want to see us build in Databutton next, let us know and we might just do it. Thanks again and we'll see you in the next video.